Hello, my dear students. In this class, I am going to explain a very important concept in financial accounting, ratio analysis. This is the second part in the fourth unit. We finished first part, final accounts. What we have discussed in the first part of fourth unit, final accounts, journal, ledger, trial balance, and financial accounting. This is the second part. Ratio analysis. We are going to discuss in this class ratio analysis. In this chapter, you are going to learn basics of ratio analysis, objectives and importance of ratio analysis, categories of ratio analysis. In the previous classes, we have discussed financial statements. What are financial statements? Trading account, profit and loss account, and balance sheet. Based on financial statements data, trading account data, profit and loss account, balance sheet, based on financial statements data, ratio analysis will be done. This is interlinked one. Financial statements, these statements aim provide financial information about the business enterprise to the needed people. To provide whatever the information they need. So as the name indicates, these are financial statements. These statements provide financial information to the needed people. Based on that information, financial information, business organizations take good decisions regarding the analysis, comparison, and the interpretation. Okay, this act is known as financial statement analysis. This act is known as financial statement analysis. Okay, the most commonly used techniques of financial statement analysis are comparative statements, common size statements, trend analysis, accounting ratios, and cash flow analysis. Okay, so only accounting ratios. This is only in your syllabus, accounting ratios. We are going to discuss only accounting ratios. Okay, so means number of techniques are there to analyze the financial, number of techniques are there to analyze the financial statements for knowing the efficiency and the profitability of the enterprise. Okay, number of techniques. So, but all these techniques, among all these techniques, we have only one technique mentioned in your syllabus, that is ratio analysis. This is present our concept ratio analysis. Okay. So, what is the meaning of ratio? What is meant by ratio analysis? Listen. So, ratio, the term ratio is a mathematical measurement. This is a mathematical yardstick. It measures the relationship between two figures or two groups of figures. The values can be expressed as a fraction, proportion, percentage, and number of times. Okay, listen once. What is meant by ratio analysis? Ratio analysis is the process of determining and interpreting numerical relationship between two terms based on financial statements. This is a process of determining, interpreting numerical relationship between two terms or two groups based on financial statements. So, these are financial statements, trading profit and loss account and balance sheet. Okay, so it measures, ratio analysis measures the profitability of the organization, efficiency of the organization, effectiveness of the organization, and it measures the financial soundness. Means organization financial position is in good condition or in average condition or in poor condition, we can decide only through ratio analysis. Clear? This is ratio analysis. So, what purpose means what are the objectives of ratio analysis? What purpose ratio analysis will be done? Okay. So, what are the objectives? What are the objectives? Through ratio analysis, we can identify the financial soundness, financial profitability condition, okay, efficiency of the business. efficiency of the management, all we can identify only through ratio analysis. What are the objectives of ratio analysis? So what are the objectives of ratio analysis? See here, to know the areas of the business which needs more attention, to know about the potential areas which can be improved with the effort in the desired direction, to know the financial position of the company, to compare the performance of one company with other company to identify best standards, to provide information derived from financial statements for decision making purpose. Listen once. What are the objectives of ratio analysis? Okay. So I will repeat again. Listen. So where to know the areas of the business means where company has to pay more attention to achieve their target results, where they have to pay more attention. In case, if it is in good financial condition, which efforts they made to get the desired level, to know the strategies, which strategies they have used to achieve their target levels. We can know through ratio analysis. Okay, so to know the financial position. In a financial position, it is in profitable zone or loss zone. So this is one of the objects. Okay, one more, to identify the best standards. By comparing, we can identify the standards. To identify the best standards and to provide valuable information for decision making. For all these purposes, ratio analysis will be done. These are the objectives of ratio analysis. See here. So, what are the importance of ratio analysis? So, what are the importance organization can get through ratio analysis? Okay, so help to know the financial position means the most important advantage of ratio analysis is it reveals the financial position of the company, the stability of the company. Through ratio analysis, organization can identify its financial position. It is in profitable zone or loss zone. They can identify through ratio analysis. This is the most important advantage of ratio analysis. And one more, identification of problem areas means ratios help to business to identify the problem areas as well as the bright areas. By identifying the problem areas, they can pay more attention to improve it. Okay, to identify problem areas, this is the one of the importance of ratio analysis. And help to understand efficiency of decisions. Okay, means ratio analysis helps a lot to understand whether the business firm has taken the right kind of decisions or not. To identify this, it is very important to analyze the ratios. Ratio analysis helps to identify whether they have taken good decisions or not. This is the advantage of ratio analysis. And through ratio analysis, organization can identify its strengths, its weaknesses, opportunities and threats. So identification of strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, threats possible. So that they can improve the strengths, they can rectify their weaknesses, they can identify valuable opportunities in the external environment. By increasing strengths, they can diffuse all the threats. All this is possible only through ratio analysis. Okay, complete SWOT analysis possible through ratio analysis. This is the most important advantage of ratio analysis. Okay, and ratio analysis helps to compare one company performance with other companies. Through comparison, we can identify the best standards. To identify best standards, this is also possible only through ratio analysis. All these help to know the financial position, identify of problem areas, help to understand efficiency of decisions, enable strengths, weaknesses, identification of strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, threats, and ratio analysis helps a lot to compare one company performance with other companies. All these are the advantages of ratio analysis. Even though it has number of advantages, it has some limitations, drawbacks. So what are the drawbacks of ratio analysis? What are the drawbacks of ratio analysis? So the most important drawback This is ratio analysis. This analysis will be done only based on the information given by the accountant. The information given by the accountant. In case, if the information is not correct, if the information is based on the guessing, the result will not be correct. The result will not be correct. So, limitation of accounting data. This is one of the drawback of ratio analysis. The complete information, ratio analysis, the result of ratio analysis depends on the information given by the accountant. The information is correct, there is no problem. We can get correct result. If the information is not correct, the result also not correct. So, limitation of accounting data, this is one of the drawback, ratio analysis. And one more limitation, accounting is nothing but recording financial transactions. Recording financial transactions in the books of accounts. Recording only financial transactions. Non-financial transactions. Non-financial transactions means non-monetary transactions are not recorded in the books of accounts. You know well, we have discussed so many times what is meant by accounting. Accounting is the language of business. Accounting is nothing but recording only financial transactions. Non-financial transactions means non-monetary transactions are not recorded in the books of accounts. So, accounting provides the information about only monetary aspects. Monetary aspects. Monetary aspects means, is quantitative aspects. Monetary aspects means quantitative aspects. Only based on this data, analysis will be done. So, ratio analysis reflects only monetary aspects. It completely ignores non-monetary aspects. It completely ignores non-monetary aspects. So, this is one of the most important drawback. It considers only monetary. It completely avoids non-monetary aspects. Why? Because only monetary transactions are recorded in the books of accounts. Only based on the financial statements, this analysis will be done. Ratio analysis. This is one of the drawback of ratio analysis. And one more drawback, there are different methods. There is no rule organizations, they have to use only particular method to evaluate any item. So there are different methods for calculating inventories, depreciation, interest, etc., etc. There are so many methods are there. Based on the requirement of the organization, based on the comfortability of the organizations, they can use any methods to measure inventories, depreciations, interests, taxes, so on so. So, a valid comparison of their financial statement is not possible. Business organizations may follow any one method. So, organizations, they may follow different methods. So, valuable comparison not possible. So, valid comparison of their financial statements not possible. Why? Because organizations may follow different methods. So, this is one of the drawback. And the most one of the drawback in ratio analysis, forecasting will be done only based on historical data. But for accurate forecasting, we should consider non-financial factors and present factors also. But this analysis will be done only based on historical. Non-monetary aspects and present values are not considered for this analysis. So, that accurate forecasting also not possible. So, these four important limitations of ratio analysis. So, ratio analysis, it has a number of advantages and some drawbacks are there. Coming to our main topic. Types of ratios. Classification of ratios. So, how many types of ratios are there? Listen. Classification of ratios. Ratios are classified into four groups. This is the basic topic. Ratios are classified into four groups. Liquidity ratios, profitability ratios, activity ratios, capital structure ratios. Activity ratios are also called turnover ratios. Capital structure ratios are also called solvency ratios. These ratios are also known as leverage ratios. So, we have four types of ratios. today we see only liquidity ratios. Today we see only liquidity ratios. Okay, the first classification of ratios are known as liquidity ratios. Okay, so listen the complete information about liquidity ratios. So remaining the information about remaining ratios we will discuss in the next sessions. So listen the information about liquidity ratios now. The organization needs two types of capital. Capital very important to start the business, to run the business, to expand the business, even to close the business. So capital must and should. Capital is the lifeblood of organization. Without sufficient capital, it is not possible to move a single inch in the business. Okay, so organization needs two types of capital. Two types of capital, fixed capital and working capital. Two types of capital. Okay, leave it fixed capital. So this is completely related to working capital. So listen the information about working capital. So to carry out day-to-day activities, organization needs sufficient working capital. Liquidity ratios determines company has sufficient working capital or not. Okay, without sufficient working capital, it is not possible to run the business. To carry out day-to-day activities of the business, it is very important working capital. Liquidity ratios, okay, determines company has sufficient working capital or not. And it reveals, liquidity ratios reveals the liquidity of the business. Liquidity of the business means it evaluates the ability of the company to pay short-term liabilities or not. It is in a position or not to pay liabilities. Okay, and it reveals liquidity of the business. Liquidity of the business means these ratios, liquidity ratios, evaluate the ability of the company to pay short-term liabilities or not. Okay, and it reveals, liquidity ratios reveals the total assets and liabilities. How much organization has assets and liabilities? How many assets are there? How many liabilities are there? Okay, so if it has ability or not to pay current liabilities, or it has sufficient working capital or not, the entire information we can get through liquidity ratios. Okay, there are three types of liquidity ratios. There are three types of liquidity ratios: current ratio, quick ratio, absolute liquid ratio. Okay, quick ratio is also called liquid ratio. It is also called acid test ratio. Quick ratio, liquidity ratio, acid test ratio. Okay, so absolute liquid ratio is also called super quick ratio. There are three types of liquidity ratios. So anyone, they may ask for your final exam. Listen carefully. Okay, three types. Separate formulas are there to calculate these three ratios. Separate formulas are there for current ratio, quick ratio and absolute liquid ratio. Okay, so listen the first one, current ratio. This is where current ratio and quick ratio both are important for your final exam. Okay, first one, current ratio. Current ratio is also called working capital ratio. Current ratio, working capital ratio, same. Okay, so current ratio, it talks about current assets and current liabilities. Current ratio tells us the relationship between current assets and current liabilities. Okay, so it is very easy to remember the formula of current ratio. Current ratio is equal to, by using this formula, we can easily calculate current ratio. Current ratio formula, current assets and current liabilities. okay, how many current assets are there, how many current liabilities are there. By using this formula, we can easily calculate current assets and current liabilities. What are current assets and what are current liabilities? Okay, current assets, all these are the complete list of current assets. This is the complete list of current liabilities. So we have already discussed in the financial accounts, in the balance sheet. Listen once again. Current assets, stock, debtors, cash and bank balance, cash in hand, cash at bank, cash and bank balances, bills receivables, accruals means future incomings, future comings, future assets, marketable securities, prepaid expenses. These are current assets. And current liabilities, creditors, outstanding expenses, short term loans, bank overdraft, provision for taxation, proposed dividend. Okay, current assets, current liabilities. Okay, so we have to identify current assets and current liabilities from the balance sheet. We have discussed balance sheet, left hand side liabilities, right hand side assets. So here liabilities include current liabilities. Okay, so short term liabilities, long term liabilities. Short term liabilities means current liabilities. Clear? Assets include fixed assets, current assets, intangible assets. Here we need current assets. So both we have to identify current assets and current liabilities from the balance sheet. Clear? So the ideal ratio, according to this, is the ideal ratio, current ratio, the ideal one, 2:1, means the ideal ratio according to the industry standards, 2:1. That means current assets should be double to current liabilities. 2:1 means current assets, current liabilities. 2:1 means current assets should be double to current liabilities. If it is double, that means business organization is in good financial position. Current assets, current liabilities. If it is double, business organization is in good financial position. If it is less than 2, ideal ratio 2:1. If it is less than 2, that means the company has inadequate financial assets. It has not sufficient financial assets. So the ideal ratio 2:1 for current ratio. Okay, so this is over current ratio. And second one, quick ratio. It is also called liquid ratio. It is also called acid test ratio. So this ratio, quick ratio, talks about quick assets and quick liabilities. It tells us the relationship between quick assets and quick liabilities. Okay. So what are quick assets and what are quick liabilities? So this is also very easy to remember the formula. Very simple formula. To calculate quick assets and quick liabilities, quick ratio is equal to quick assets and quick liabilities. Here we can consider quick liabilities, we can consider as current liabilities. Okay, listen once. Quick ratio formula, quick assets divided by quick liabilities. Quick liabilities means current liabilities. What are current liabilities? Just we have discussed. These are current liabilities. Both are same meaning words. Quick liabilities and current liabilities. But what are quick assets? Okay. Except stock and prepaid expenses, all current assets are quick assets. Listen once. Except stock and prepaid expenses, all are current assets. Okay. So why we should deduct stock and prepaid expenses from current assets. Why we should deduct? Just I told to you, quick assets is equal to current assets minus stock minus prepaid expenses. Except stock and prepaid expenses, all current assets, quick assets. Why we should deduct these two, stock and prepaid expenses? Okay, quick assets are those which are easily converted into cash with only 90 days duration. Okay, here stock means finished goods. Stock means stock two types, opening stock, closing stock, both are finished goods. Stock means finished goods. Finished goods we can't immediately sold. Even though we may sold, we may not get money immediately. Okay, we may not get money immediately. So we should deduct stock from current assets. Okay, and prepaid expenses. These are not assets. These are paid before. So that we should deduct prepaid expenses also from current assets. Overall, quick assets formula. Current assets minus stock minus prepaid expenses. Okay, remember once, we should deduct stock and prepaid expenses from current assets. The ideal quick ratio 1:1. The ideal quick ratio 1:1. That means quick assets should be equal to quick liabilities. Okay, if it is equal to quick liabilities, quick assets are equal to quick liabilities, we can say the organization is in good financial condition. Otherwise, we can say the financial position of the organization is not good. Okay, this is. And the next third one, absolute liquid ratio. Absolute liquid ratio. Absolute liquid ratio, it measures the cash availability of the firm to meet the current liabilities. The cash availability of the firm to meet current liabilities. Means if an organization has sufficient cash to meet current liabilities or not, we can know through absolute liquid ratio. Okay, it tells us the relationship between absolute liquid assets and quick liabilities. It tells us the relationship between absolute liquid assets and quick liabilities. Quick liabilities are also called liquid liabilities. Okay, so here separate formula is there to calculate absolute liquid ratio. Absolute liquid ratio is equal to absolute liquid assets divided by quick liabilities. Quick liabilities are nothing but current liabilities. So what are current liabilities? These are current liabilities. These are current liabilities. Okay. So absolute liquid assets, only three we have to consider as absolute liquid assets. Cash, bank balance and marketable securities. These we take for absolute liquid assets. Quick liabilities we can consider as current liabilities. Okay, the ideal ratio is 1:2. If the ratio is greater than 1, it means resource management is not good. It means resource management is not good. Okay, and liquidity is very high. It means liquidity is also very high. High liquidity means low profitability. So the ideal ratio always 1:2. Absolute liquid assets 1, current liabilities 2. This is the ideal ratio. Clear? Okay. So we will discuss the problems in the next video.